whatever I have discussed now, let us see in this form of this chart, where you can see the ovarian cycle. You can see, so ovarian cycle 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. At the 14th day, on the 14th day, ovulation occurs. What is meant by ovulation? Release of egg. Release of egg from the ovary. Are you following? So, release of egg from the ovary is called as ovulation when it is occurring on the 14th day. On the 14th day, and this process is called as ovulation. Condition when the females are healthy and they have no other exceptional conditions. This will definitely occur. So, this is under the influence of which hormone? This is under the influence of follicle stimulating hormone. Okay. Now, you can see these are all the different types of follicles. On the 14th day, the ovulation occurs and the egg is released. Can you see? Here, what is that hormone which is also playing a vital role? It is estradiol. If the females are not having some or the some defects or the some diseases like, then external injections in the form of estradiols will be given by the gynecologist to that particular girls or females. So this is what is called as the, on the 14th day it is ovulation. Now coming to the next, that is the luteal phase. On the 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26 and 28, what is happening? When the fertilization doesn't occur, what is happening? The corpus albinicus will be formed. Corpus luteum will be changing into corpus albinicus, and this is called as luteal phase, where we are showing on the 22nd day. This is again important. On the 22nd day, the level of luteinizing hormone secretion is more. It is increasing on the 22nd day, and thus what is happening gradually on the 24th, 26th and 28 days, you can see the follicle is being reducing. So when the follicle, here see how much big it is there, it is growing smaller and it is reducing. With this, on the 28th day, what is happening? The endometrium will fall. It falls and the blood oozes out from the blood oozes out from the vagina. So this is called as the bleeding. Understood? So this is the complete menstrual cycle which occurs in the females. Hope you have understood it. The only thing is, the main importance is the role of hormones, how they are influencing, and the production of ova, formation of egg, and the different types of hormones which are influencing the female in the menstrual cycle.